11 years old when I got matched with a fellow who was a student at Princeton University. His name was Carl DiAngio, and he was a pre-med working very hard. He was a track star. And I lived in a little town about 8 miles from Princeton. Single working mom, household, two sisters. You know, just having a guy that I could talk to and that could be inspirational to me was great.
And so I met Gail. She was tall, she was tan, she had big gray eyes, grayish green eyes, and she drove a convertible cabriolet, and my Barbie had one, so I want you to know she was cool to me.
And it was just great to have a guy to confide in, to ask questions, you know, who'd been through it, who I could identify with, who was cool enough to be accessible, but, you know, also a role model. That was a really meaningful thing.
She turned me on to theater. She taught me to fish. We played tennis, we just did everything. And it got to a point where I could confide in her about things that were going on with me that my folks were just too busy.
It was sort of an opening of the world. It was saying to you know, an adolescent kid who by definition is a little confused, you know, you can get out of this little world that you live in and you know, aspire to do big things.
I can think back in a few times in my life when I realized the road less taken was too hard for me, or I thought it was too hard for me, and I wanted to do what everyone else was doing. And she said a long time ago, you are not those girls. She says, I don't know why you're trying to be like them and they want to be like you. So I was constantly redirected. I was constantly reassured. My confidence was constantly built by her.
Got a package full of wishes, a time machine, a magic wand, a globe made out of gold. Printed on the box I see, Acme's built a world to be. Take a chance, grab a piece, help me to believe it. What kind of world do you want? Think anything. History starts now.